So plan of the day is to do the handbrake cable. So the handbrake cable still is very functional on this car, but because it's lived on a hill for a long period of its life, I think there's definitely stretch in the cables. And I initially went in to the rear drums and replaced the handbrake shoes. Out of interest, this car's done nearly 150,000 miles. You don't really ever need to replace those, but I was in there. I was like, oh, I've bought the parts now, just stick them on. But I found that the little adjuster inside there that pushes the shoes against the drum on the rear disc had reached its maximum capacity, and particularly on the driver side rear, it couldn't go any further. So it almost suggests that the cable must be looser on that side, which to me doesn't sound very safe, that basically the car is being held mostly on the near side cable, and got to make it perfect. So what I'll need to do is take the center console out to gain access to the handbrake itself, the actual mechanism, undo that, but I'll need to release the cable tension. There's a little spring how to do that. And then we're going to raise the rear of the car up, take the wheels off, take the drums off, release the handbrake cable from where those shoes are, and then pull it out from underneath where it sits near the heat shielding, where the exhaust is, and then put these new ones in. So I'll show you some of the stuff that I've got ready for it. Right, who knows what the order you should do these things in, but I'm going to start with what I know first, which is releasing. There's a spring that sits in here that you need to release the tension off the handbrake cable. Mega spanner is really handy. Got this off these Blostum. Who knows that brand? But it's more just for the leverage. So there's a little indent. Let's take that out. Car's trying to start itself. With my elbow. Right, I've got to push this back with the handbrake off. Remember, it's in gear. Double check that. So handbrake off. Right, that's in.
There was something about her face, something about the way that they would taste. Little lips after slipping everything she shouldn't save, and taking everything that couldn't wait. Saying wouldn't it be great, a little bait, heard a little late. Years of trying me finally, I'ma slip her on a date. Saying wait, the day will break, trying to play it straight. But she was saying wake me up at 8, now I'm talking late. Jack, way back when I had eczema on my elbows, before she found shelter in the shell toes. We felt those lows, the heaven in the hell holes, waiting for a situation saying we should quell those.
So this wasn't very obvious, and there's nothing that mentions this on any of the videos on YouTube, but it's this little panel is the last bit that needs to come out. What I used is this. You probably could use something else, and I've slightly scuffed it, but I'll probably just sand that off afterwards. And what that reveals is the last screw here. So I'm going to take that out, and then hopefully the rest will follow.
Hellholes waiting for a situation, saying we should quell those feelings we're feeling. Cause I don't get no ease in the evening, release when I'm dreaming. And she would say she can't believe what she's reading, cause everything I write's been misleading. She needs it. She needs him. She needs it. She needs him. She needs it. She needs him. She needs it. She
don't need to take it all the way out, so I'm gonna rest it. See what I've done there. Resty, resty. Okay, I'm definitely gonna give this a hoover afterwards. Alright. I'm gonna sort out my tools a bit. So this is an airbag, I think. And you know what I'm gonna do then? I'm gonna disconnect the battery because I'm pretty sure that's an airbag. And I don't fancy that going off. Right. Right, so that was a bit stuck, so that probably doesn't help things. This is the other side, it's got a bit better visual. So that's the joint. Do not put any crimps or anything on there because you'll actually make your life harder. There's a little clip here which you just pop the cable out from. And then, let's see if I can. And then just do lots of wiggle, 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 wiggle. And you can see it's already coming loose. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. A little bit more WD-40 in there. Good stuff. Come out. I'm going to use my right hand. What I'm going to do is put some... Placing your two pads, you put your adjustment mechanism obviously down to its lowest amount, and then place the top spring, so then that's all mounted there, and then you slot in the mechanism here that attaches to the brake cable, sorry, the handbrake cable, and then put this over the top and just put it in its little grooves. I connected the last, so then I put the just positioning screws in. They only go a right angle and then they lock in. And then I placed the bottom part of this spring here. And I found actually the easiest way was hooking with a screwdriver here, but leaning back like that to then push it onto the clip. It's really hard to do, but that seemed to work. So, undo that. Yeah, buddy. Alright. It's at this point she knew she fucked up. Had to go back in and sell that shit. Okay, so we are at... next day, because I did do a video of this last night, but it was very dark and I thought I'd do this with a fresh face. So, success. The only thing I found when I'd put everything back and I went to take it for a test drive, I couldn't put the handbrake, if I put it on now, couldn't put it all the way down because I'd accidentally put the seatbelt inside the console, so had to take that off to fix it. But to show you, that's... Now, one, two, three. Okay, well, you can do more clicks, but before it was definitely much higher, whereas this now feels just normal and it feels really snug. So a few tips that I would say in hindsight of doing it. So for a start, be careful when you've got, if you've got an S-drive car, I'm not sure about the mechanics of this. Someone might be able to tell me that if it's rear wheel drive, if the rear is off the floor, does putting it into gear still create a brake in a sense? Or yeah, anyway, but I put loads of sandbags at the front. So basically don't do it on uneven ground or any form of slope and have chocks on the front wheels that you keep, you know, checking those because you don't want the car rolling off. Other things that were good learning points. So to actually take off the center console, it's not hard, but nobody shows you this, but there is a sneaky little bolt in here, and in order to get to it you have to push this seat all the way forward. It's really awkward. Why did they do that? But that's the last bolt that I found a bit annoying to get to, but everything else is pretty straightforward. And disconnect the battery because you've got an airbag in there, you don't want to set that off by accident. Other things that I found, So definitely take a photo of your brake, you know, the handbrake shoe mechanism. Take some photos of that. I'm going to put it in my video as well, because the E84, although it's very similar to lots of other BMWs, there's just slight little things like which spring, you know, is it the fat spring or the small spring that goes at the top or the bottom, and which way around the shoes go. And I had to find a video that I'd done for myself a while ago, which I'll put in, that helped remind me how to do it. And that took me a bit of time, so I was just faffing. And another thing is the adjuster mechanism that sits inside, you know, that pushes the shoes out to get the tension on the handbrake. Sometimes they can seize up, and I reckon it might have been worth actually just buying new ones, but I didn't have them. And I think that's what BMW were quoting for when I got the quote for them. They had loads of additional kind of brackets and grommets and things, because at the end of the day, some of these things are a bit dead. And certainly on the near side, there was a bolt that just kind of holds the cable into the back of the drum that was seized, so Dremeled that off. It might have been nice to have just had new parts of all of those. What else? You do not need to get any heat shielding off. Do not clamp anywhere near where the some people online talk about that they had to clamp the cable to pull it out of there. Don't do that, because if you narrow that area, you will cause it to block. All I did was wiggle loads of WD-40. I pre-prepped that a week before spraying under there. If you've put the red nozzle on your WD-40, you can reach up there easily, and that really helped. Other things, can't think of anything else really. Yeah, I think that was the main things. It's not hard to do, it's just there's lots of steps, and if you know how to do it, I could do it again a lot quicker. But yeah, main things were putting the pads back in, faff, and how to get the center console off. Oh, the other thing is when you get to the end and you're adjusting the handbrake tension, don't adjust one side up really tight first, because it will, because it's all linked, you won't be able to feel how tense the other side is. So you'll see in the video, I actually got them both up to just a little bit so I could just about turn the discs, and then did like about a quarter turn for either side, and that made it nice and tight. I think when BMW do it, they put it on a special road or something like that. They do something to make it perfect, as they would the BMW. And but yeah, that was a good tip. But it just feels tighter. And even though the cables, when I looked at them, were the same length, I think that you get a natural, almost, it's losing its tensile strength or something, the cabling. So although, I mean, it may be a few millimeters longer, I didn't look at it that detail, but it definitely feels tighter. And interesting, the brakes feel better. So I think actually just getting in there, cleaning those out probably helped. You know, they just feel a bit tighter on the pedal. I didn't do anything particular to them, just clean them. So yeah, that's it. Jobs are good. And so BMW were going to charge me £500 in labor to do that. Parts for me were 50 quid, and yeah, so that saved me 500 quid. So well worth doing. Hope that helps people. Yay.